In India, the uncertainty over the economic outlook was highest this year, especially after the devastating second wave. After fighting several odds, the country's economy is on a steady path of recovery, as per the experts' opinion. After a long term and the GDP's development rate has recovered, and India's economy is expected to grow at 8.5% rate in 2022, according to the International Monetary Fund projections. The government infrastructure push, effective monetary policy, widening of the performance-linked incentive scheme, structural reforms, crypto and digital assets, along with the boost in financial technology in rural India, are one of the major components that are expected to fuel the economic recovery. The effective monetary policy and the monetary policy committee of those RBI department that kept the repo rate under the liquidity adjustment facility that unchanged at 4%, the reverse repo rate also at 3.35% as unchanged, and the marginal standing facility rate and the bank rate at 4.25%. We continue to expect the RBI to fine-tune the surplus liquidity to manage the rates and consequently provide the guidance on the operating target rate, shifting closer to the repo. We expect a reverse repo hike of around 20 bps possible in the February policy and a more aggressive liquidity withdrawal. The early estimates suggest that all the constituents of aggregate demand that will further enter the expansion zone will export and import the marked exceeding the pre-COVID level. The center is going to spend a peak on booster shots of these vaccines, health infrastructures in the smaller cities, the welfare scheme for the poor, food subsidy, easier loan access for the smallest borrowers, and the capital expenditure. The capex and infrastructure development will be based on 111 lakh crore national infrastructure pipeline of PM Goti Shakti that can decrease the logistic cost of 13 to 8% in the next 4 to 5 years. India is no hurry to withdraw the coronavirus stimulus measures, which will provide the support needed for the economic growth, and the policy like an increase in the stimulus package, production link incentive scheme, and the project management professional that will attract for the foreign investment, along with those initiatives to going to help the Indian economy to avoid a severe downturn. The crypto and the focus on its regulation are one of the trends that will dominate in 2022. The upcoming stage is termed as Web 3.0 by the industry, where the decentralized internet draws on blockchain technology and the data owned by the consumers can help the Indian economic growth and boost its GDP. The digital assets such as cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, the central bank digital currency, non-fungible tokens and other that can help the India to achieve the US 1 trillion economy by 2030. According to the US-India Strategic Partnership Forum and US-based crypto exchange Cross Tower, the different sectors utilizing the blockchain technologies like healthcare, supply chain, loyalty and rewards, the payment and the remittance, the financial services and art can add up to the many amount in respective scale. I mean, it's a large amount of many sectors are involved that going to be achieved to the 2032 deadline. The financial technology adoption in rural India is going to increase in 2022, which is said to stage for the rural economy to grow. Recently, the Indian Bank Association to boost the presence of the banking services in rural India. That also an important step that can be measured. And RBI also has initiated those payment investment development fund. And this scheme aims to add 30 lakh digital payment touch point in the Tier 3 to Tier 6 areas along with the northeastern state. Meanwhile, the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology is going to establish the common service centers as the digital financial hubs. The centers have invested over the 65 crores to promote the digital financial services such as IMPS, UPI, bank, POS machine. This will lead to the awareness among the rural people about the governmental policy and digital finance operation available for them. The private companies are also not lagging, and the e-commerce giant Amazon also invested 225 crore in this in the Indian digital payment arm, and it's estimated to corner 64% of the market share by 2025. Actually, the several fintech companies that provide those innovative technologies like voice-based payment solutions. In case of these voice-based payment solutions, no need of internet is required, and the smartphone to merge the fintech with agriculture, education and the healthcare. These developments are all set to take place in 2022. Will set a stage for India to become a digital first economy, digital frontier in the economic prospect even in the coming years. The South Asian nation, India going to be a leader in the South Asian nation that can enable the digital payment, that enable the digital payment system in the coming years. They are the leader. I mean, many other countries will follow India in case of this type of states, this kind of initiative in the digital world platform, digital finance platform. The government policies has put in the place to enable the faster growth in the private investment, especially with the production linked incentive scheme, and also the introduce of design linked incentive scheme for the semiconductor devices. In the semiconductor industry, a new investment in the government of India provides for the 75,000 crore rupees. That initiative is based on design linked incentive scheme. And along with the investment in the PLI scheme, the reduction in corporate tax rates, and the reality is these private sector companies have not been forthcoming with the capacity building investment. The criticality of this fiscal policy is also borne out by the fact that the various segment of the economy continues to face different kind of stress. Interest rate tools may not be the best suited in these situations. It is probably the time for the consumer to receive some help from the fiscal side, also as the lure of the extremely low interest rate likely to grow in future. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.